Dear colleagues, my name is Klaus Kopka, head of the division Radiopharmaceutical Chemistry within the research program Imaging and Radio-Oncology of the German Cancer Research Center in Heidelberg, Germany. I would like to give a comprehensive overview of a recent topic in our field, radiopharmaceutical chemistry, the prostate-specific membrane antigen, PSMA, a zinc protease and ideal biological target for tailor-made low molecular weight radioligands, and I will include some radiochemical concepts for PSMA targeting within the next couple of minutes. Within the field radiopharmaceutical chemistry, we follow the modern radiotracer principle. We develop and manufacture radioactive pharmaceuticals, in short, radiopharmaceuticals. After their reformulation in saline buffered solution, the sterile injection solution is intravenously injected by a nuclear physician. The given radiotracer distributes through the body of a corresponding patient. By this means, for example, transport systems, enzymes, or receptors can be non-invasively imaged, depending on the molecule chosen for targeting of the corresponding biological target. By attaching a radio label onto the molecule without changing its targeting properties, we have here access to the highly sensitive and non-invasive detection of oncological, cardiological, and neurological diseases at the subcellular and molecular level by means of modern positron emission tomography, PET, as well as single photon emission computed tomography, SPECT. For example, we can use gallium-68 labeled PSMA inhibitors, a very new class of new targeted radioligands, labeled with a modern positron emitter gallium-68 for the non-invasive imaging of PSMA positive lesions in patients suffering from prostate cancer. In our field, radiopharmaceutical chemistry, we have the capability to design radiopharmaceuticals for both diagnosis using positron and gamma emitters and for so-called endoradiotherapy using beta minus particle emitters by attaching the different radionuclides on the same targeting chemical entity, that is to say, on the same pharmacophoric binding motif. So we have access to a so-called in vivo theranostic approach. During the developmental process of new radioligands, we revert to organic or peptide synthesis of a tailor-made targeted radiolabeling precursor, which can be radiolabeled in the last synthesis step. After establishing the radiosynthesis, normally preclinical in vivo evaluation studies in experimental mouse models with the upregulated receptor to be addressed are performed before entering into first-in-man studies, which is intended after successful preclinical evaluation. Within the in vivo theranostic approach, in another step, after non-invasive pre-staging with the diagnostic version, the therapeutic version, in this case labeled with a particle emitter radioiodine 131, can be applied as individual treatment option for the patient. The prostate-specific membrane antigen, PSMA, also called glutamate carboxypeptidase 2 or folate hydrolase 1, is a 750 amino acid cell surface glycoprotein and a membrane-bound B-nuclear zinc protease. PSMA is normally upregulated to some extent in brain, kidneys, spleen, intestines, salivary glands, and the prostate itself. However, PSMA is highly upregulated in all stages of prostate cancer. PSMA thus represents an ideal biological target for the detection and therapy of prostate cancer. There exist two main endogenous substrates to be cleaved by PSMA, the most abundant mammalian peptidic neurotransmitter, N-acetyl N-Aspartyl-L-Glutamate, NAAG, controlling the glutamatergic system of the brain, and folyl-poly-gamma-glutamate, which is cleaved in the PSMA-positive enterocytes of the intestines, both resulting in the release of glutamate. Both substrates bind to the zinc active site of PSMA, with glutamate reaching into the S1 prime pocket of the membrane-type protein. Now, the very beginning idea was to mimic the binding to the zinc active site by the introduction of small molecules bearing a proteolytically more stable chemical function instead of the amide bond to be cleaved in the natural substrates. Clifford Bergman and co-workers from Washington State University examined a variety of so-called pseudo-irreversible phosphoamidate-based PSMA inhibitors and so-called rapid-reversible phosphonomethyl-based PSMA inhibitors, and you see here underlined in blue the necessary carboxylic acid functions as well as small aromatic moieties underlined in green within the molecules needed for their binding interactions with the receptor. As one prerequisite, it is obvious that small aromatic moieties are necessary for improved internalization in corresponding prostate tumor cells. In fact, Bayer, some years ago, had decided to design a new phosphonomethyl-based inhibitor derived from 2-PMPA. These kind of known inhibitors mimicking the binding of NAAG to the zinc active site of PSMA served as basic structure for first small molecule PSMA tracers. One of the lead candidates, called BI-1075553, was radiolabeled with the prominent positron emitter fluorine 18, resulting in a nice PET-compatible PSMA-targeted radioligand, which showed a promising performance in small animal PET imaging studies and a nice uptake in PSMA-positive LNCAP prostate tumor-bearing mice. However, BI-1075553 failed in the improved detection of prostate cancer lesions as compared with the hitherto used radiofluorinated PET tracer fluoromethylcholine, which showed obviously a high detection rate of prostate oligometastases. F18 labeled pseudo-irreversible phosphoamidate-based PSMA inhibitors, such as FBLW54, a highly potent inhibitor when considering the Ki value, was also preclinically evaluated in vivo by means of micro-PET studies in PSMA-positive LNCAP tumor-bearing mice. Specificity of radiotracer uptake in LNCAP tumors was proven by blocking experiments as well as by micro-PET studies in PSMA-negative PC3 prostate tumor-bearing mice. As expected, uptake could also be observed in kidneys, which normally express PSMA in the proximal tubuli. Further clinical examination of this PSMA-targeted tracer cannot be found in the literature. In parallel, it became more and more clear that PSMA inhibitors with glu-ureidomotive, including an additional carboxylic acid function like in the here shown green underlined structure in the middle, represent the hitherto optimal lead structure for the design of PSMA-targeted radioligands, both for diagnosis and endoradiotherapy in nuclear medicine. From the knowledge of the structural biology of PSMA, this lead structure fits elegantly within the zinc active site as well as in the S1 prime subpocket with the feasibility to chemically alter the substituent R with maximal flexibility. Already early 2000, Alan Kosikowski and co-workers, especially Fajul Nunn, Paola Conti and Tsang from Georgetown University, Washington DC, invented the first urea-based PSMA inhibitor by rational design, starting from the natural substrate N-acetyl-L-glutamate. This glue-ureido-glue motive is now called DUPA, derived from decarboxypropyl ureido-pentanedioic acid, showing a 1-digit nanomolar PSMA inhibition potency. DUPA is the key PSMA inhibitor and lead structure, bearing the unique green underlined pharmacophoric unit, which enabled since then the design of all urea-based PSMA-targeted radioligands until now. In cooperation with Martin D. Pomper from Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine in Baltimore, the very first examples of radiolabeled glue-ureido-based small molecular PSMA inhibitors were originally presented in the years 2002 and 5. The cysteinyl-derived variant was labeled with a positron emitter C11, having a physical half-life of 20 minutes, by C11 methylation of the thiol function, resulting in the radioligand C11-DCMC, with a Ki value of 3.1 nanomolar. The tyrosine-derived variant was labeled with radioiodine 1-5 by electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction using the Eudogene method, resulting in the radioligand iodine 1-5-D-CIT with a Ki value of 1.5 nanomolar. As you can see for the radioiodinated version, D-CIT, this radioligand was indeed able to in vivo visualize PSMA-positive LNCAP tumors by means of small animal planar gamma scintigraphy studies. Within the same mouse, the corresponding tracer uptake into the PSMA-negative PC3 tumor was only marginal, proving the specificity of the tracer uptake. Improved versions of radioiodinated haloaromatic PSMA inhibitors have been presented some years later by the group of John Babbage during his time at Molecular Insight Pharmaceuticals, MIP, in Cambridge, Massachusetts. On the left-hand side, you see the compound MIP-1072 and the compound MIP-1095 on the right-hand side, bearing either a para-iodobenzyl moiety directly attached to the epsilon amine function of the lysine-derived pharmacophore, or via a para-iodophenyl moiety linked to the molecule via an urea function. MIP-1095 indicated a higher PSMA inhibition potency as compared with MIP-1072. The SPECT-compatible iodine 1-2-3 labeled versions showed a good ability to image PSMA-positive LNCAP prostate tumor xenografts, and as mentioned before, the terminal aromatic moieties obviously contributed to a better tumor uptake of these radioiodinated versions of PSMA-targeted radioligands. After realization of the organ distribution studies in the same mouse model, it was decided to translate radioiodinated MIP-1095 into first-in-man studies as this promising radiotracer showed a higher tumor uptake and at the same time a reduced kidney uptake. Indeed, in cooperation with the Department of Nuclear Medicine of the Heidelberg University Hospital in Germany, John Babbage started a translational research collaboration with the clinical director Uwe Haberkorn so that a first-in-man study could be initiated with the iodine-124 labeled version of MIP-1095, having a physical half-life of approximately 4 days in a patient suffering from progressive prostate cancer, that is to say from metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer. Please look at the impressive clearance of iodine-124 MIP-1095 from normal organs and tissues over a few days, whereby the radiotracer uptake and the PSMA-positive tumor lesions is maintained, altogether resulting in a spectacular high tumor-to-background contrast, which is exemplified by this positron emission tomography scan. This impressive result encouraged Uwe Haberkorn to initiate since then individual endoradiotherapeutic applications with iodine-131 beta-minus particle emitter labeled version of MIP-1095. The very first EGFR-based PSMA inhibitor labeled with a prominent positron emitter fluorine-18, having a physical half-life of 110 minutes, F18 DCFBC, again a cysteinyl-derived glu-ureido derivative, was presented by the group of Martin Pomper and co-workers, that is to say by Ronnie Mies and Steve Cho, which was preclinically evaluated in vivo in PSMA-positive tumor-bearing mice. However, this radiofluorinated variant did not show an optimally maintained tumor uptake in the experimental mouse model. Rather, a clearance from the tumor could be observed already 2 hours post-injection. Anyhow, DCFBC was transferred into a first-in-man study, and as you can see on the bottom right, the tracer indeed accumulated in tumor lesions, as highlighted by the arrows, but surprisingly also was remained in the blood pool over 2 hours, which excluded this PSMA radioligand variant from further clinical studies. This was obviously the reason why Martin Pomper's group switched back to the lysine-derived glu-ureido variants and finally introduced the radiofluorinated tracer F18 DCFPYL, in which F18 fluoronicotinic acid was introduced as a so-called prosthetic group at the epsilon amine function. Up to now, this radiofluorinated version of a small molecular PSMA inhibitor is at the moment one of the most promising diagnostic PET-compatible PSMA-targeted radioligands, as already can figured out from the here shown preclinical organ distribution study, showing a very high tracer uptake of 39.5% ID per gram uptake in the PSMA-positive tumor and a reduced kidney uptake 2 hours post-injection. Meanwhile, this most promising radiofluorinated PSMA PET radioligand was recently transferred into the clinical scenario by the same group from Johns Hopkins Medical Institutions in Baltimore. And you nicely can see here the improved biodistribution behavior of F18 DCFPYL as examined over 150 minutes after intravenous injection, indicating a very high imaging contrast as well as a high detection rate of PSMA-positive tumor lesions in a patient suffering from progressive disease. In early August 2015, this radiotracer was licensed to the pharmaceutical company Progenix in New York. Several groups attempted to also design PSMA-targeted radioligands bearing the prominent and clinically relevant single-photon emitter technetium-99m. Again, Martin Pomper's group, in this case Sanjita Ray Banerjee, succeeded in the design of technetium-99m tricarbonyl labeled conjugate with aliphatic linker moiety located between the pharmacophore and the radiometal complex moiety, which was realized by use of the click-to-chelate concept of Tom Mint and co-workers from Switzerland. This highly potent PSMA inhibitor showed a high tracer uptake in PSMA-positive tumor-bearing mice, which has the same order of magnitude of that of F18-DCF-PYL mentioned before. As expected, a maintained kidney uptake could be observed. The authors concluded these results indicate that consideration of the chelating agent is critical and must be carefully considered when beginning a new campaign to find the most clinically viable technetium-99m labeled agent for compounds of this class. Anyhow, the two technetium-99m tricarbonyl labeled variants, which are derived either from the aforementioned duperlite structure MIP-1404 or from the lysine-derived glue-oreodomotive MIP-1405, were tripodal imidazolyl methyl amine chelators with three acetic acid moieties were used, are until now the SPECT tracers of choice, which already entered into human applications to non-invasively image prostate cancer by means of single photon emission computed tomography SPECT. Both compounds were designed by John Babich and co-workers during his time at Molecular Insight Pharmaceuticals MIP. Especially compound MIP-1404, already showing a nice preclinical performance 24 hours post-injection in PSMA-positive tumor-bearing mice, illustrated on the top right-hand side, is meanwhile also licensed to Progenix in New York. MIP-1404 has already entered prospective clinical trials several years ago. To my knowledge, the phase 2 trial could be finalized and the phase 3 trial is initiated for the detection of prostate cancer at high risk by means of SPECT. As meanwhile, the positron emitter gallium-68, a trivalent cation, is available through germanium-68, gallium-68 radionuclide generators. Again, Martin Pomper's group started to establish a PSMA-targeted radio conjugate by combining a rather long linker moiety consisting of zuberic acid, L-lysine, and 2-times-L-phenylalanine, with the known metal chelator DOTA. However, despite the fact that this compound showed a high PSMA inhibition potency in vitro, the tracer tumor uptake in the corresponding PSMA-positive tumor-bearing mice was not very high. Surprisingly, maintaining the same linker variant between the pharmacophoric unit and the chelator, now choosing the N-N-bridge cyclam-based chelating agent CBTE2A for chelation of the positron emitter copper-64 again resulted in a very high tumor uptake of this copper-64-labeled PSMA radioligand in the same tumor model. This proves that chelating agents obviously have a high impact on the molecule's PSMA targeting properties and pharmacokinetics in vivo. Technical University Munich, here the group of Hans-Jürgen Wester and co-workers, again maintained the linker moiety consisting of zuberic acid, lysine and 2× phenylalanine, but in this case they used the D-forms of the amino acids and exchanged the chelator DOTA against the also available chelator DOTAGA, which also can easily coordinate to trivalent cations. Martina Weineisen nicely showed that obviously the D-isomeric linker moiety improves the tumor uptake, see gray bars, as compared with the L variant of Martin Pomper's group, see white bars. And the biodistribution behavior of their compound shows almost the same performance as gallium-68 PSMA-11, which is also called by jargon the Heidelberg compound, see black bars. I will come back to the Heidelberg compound later. Hans-Jürgen Wester's group from Technical University Munich now presented a second generation of their DOTAGA conjugate and exchanged 1-D-phenylalanine unit against the iodinated D-tyrosine unit. This conjugate is called PSMA I and T, I for imaging and T for therapy. As chelating agents such as DOTA and DOTAGA can also be used for the complexation of lanthanides such as lutetium-177, which is a commercially available beta-minus particle emitter, which can be used on an individual basis for systemic radionuclide therapy, in this case for PSMA-targeted endoradiotherapy of patients with progressive prostate cancer, we hold here in our hands a compound for in vivo theragnostics in nuclear medicine. For example, you see here on the bottom right hand side either an example of a PET scan of a patient 1 given a dose of gallium-68 PSMA INT, gallium-68 having a physical half-life of 68 minutes, and an example of a planar scintigraphy of patient 2 given a dose of lutetium-177 PSMA INT, lutetium-177 having a physical half-life of 6.7 days. The significant accumulation of these radiotracers in PSMA-positive lesions as well as in normal organs such as kidneys and salivary glands can be nicely followed. Now, what is interesting to notice is that already in the year 2011, my predecessor, Michael Eisenhut, with the help of Matthias Eder and co-workers of my division, such as Martin Schäfer, cleverly combined the already known lipophilic, highly efficient, acyclic gallium-3-plus chelating agent HBETCC with the hydrophilic lysine-derived glue oreido pharmacophore and inserted an additional aminohexanoic acid linker into the molecule. The chelating agent HBETCC was developed by Schumacher and co-workers at the German Cancer Research Center in Heidelberg already in the 1990s. After successful preclinical in vivo evaluation, including micro-PET studies, the HBETCC PSMA-targeted radiotracer was successfully introduced by Uwe Haberkorn in the Department of Nuclear Medicine of the Heidelberg University Hospital, for PSMA PET-CT diagnosis, staging, as well as for therapy monitoring of prostate cancer. Alone in Heidelberg, approximately 1,000 patients have been examined with this Heidelberg compound so far, which is now called gallium-68 PSMA-11. The co-worker of Uwe Habakorn, Ali Afshar Oromi, meanwhile has been honored with two Best Clinical Paper Awards of the European Association of Nuclear Medicine, EANM. The radiolabeling precursor PSMA-11 is meanwhile commercially available from ABX Advanced Biochemical Compounds in Radeberg, Germany. That is the reason why gallium-68 PSMA-11 is now available in university hospitals and research institutions worldwide. And meanwhile, gallium-68 PSMA-11 is applied in many PET centers and nuclear medicine departments, for example in North America, Europe, Asia, and Australia. As we are quite familiar with the structure property relationships of gallium-68 PSMA-11, in parallel, my division of radiopharmaceutical chemistry worked together with our PhD student Martina Benežová and Matthias Eder also on a theragnostic version of a PSMA targeted radioligand, which can be used both for diagnosis, the gallium-68 labeled version, and endoradiotherapy, the lutetium-177 labeled version, of prostate cancer. The aim was to reduce the linker version between the pharmacophore and the chelator and to use again DOTA as radiometal complexing agent. However, we intended to at least maintain or even improve the properties of the aimed at novel theragnostic compound as compared with PSMA-11. Indeed, out of roughly 30 synthesized DOTA conjugates, we could identify one very promising candidate with the best structural property relationships. We successfully have patented this novel class of theragnostic PSMA-targeted radioligands and call our candidate PSMA-617. By simply introducing a 2-naphthyl alanine and a trans-aminomethyl cyclohexane carboxylic acid unit within the linker region and attaching the DOTA chelator, we observed that highest internalization ratios into the PSMA-positive prostate tumor cells and the best biodistribution behavior, as shown here for gallium-68 labeled PSMA-617, indicated a maintained tumor uptake of the radiotracer over 2 hours and at the same time an already beginning kidney clearance, at least observed in the experimental mouse model, which is naturally desired. A first dosimetric human study with gallium-68 PSMA-617 was recently presented by Ali Afshar Oromi, resulting, for example, in an impressive PET scan over several hours, showing that gallium-68 PSMA-617 can increasingly accumulate into the PSMA-positive primary tumor, see blue and red arrows, as well as curves for standardized uptake values, SUVs. The average effective dose determined for 19 patients was only 0.021 millisieverts per megabecquerel. Meanwhile, PSMA-617 was licensed to ABX Advanced Biochemical Compounds in Radeberg, Germany. In early 2015, Uwe Habakorn's group, again here Clemens Kratochwil, showed the first endoradiotherapeutic application using lutetium-177 labeled PSMA-617. The patient was examined by PET pre-staging with the diagnostic Heidelberg compound gallium-68 PSMA-11. See red arrows pointing to the PSMA-positive metastases. After giving the same patient several cycles of lutetium-177 PSMA-617, the final PET scan, again using gallium-68 PSMA-11, indicated a complete radiological remission of the PSMA-positive lesions. See again red arrows as orientation. The recent chemical and radiochemical work of our PhD student Martina Benežová, together with all supervising co-workers in my division, and the successful transfer of PSMA-617 into first clinical endoradiotherapeutic applications using the lutetium-labeled version, was honored with the 2015 Image of the Year Award given during the annual meeting of the Society of Nuclear Medicine and Molecular Imaging, SNMMI, in Baltimore. And you see here on the right-hand side the image of the year 2015, which speaks for itself. Meanwhile, many nuclear medicine departments in Germany and several centers in other countries just have started to use lutetium-177 PSMA-617 for the individual PSMA-targeted endoradiotherapy of patients suffering from metastatic castration-resistant prostate cancer, which offers a new treatment option for patients suffering from late-stage disease. In a next step, a prospective multi-center clinical trial has to be realized to prove the clinical value of this new theranostic PSMA radioligand, PSMA-617. With these impressions of low molecular weight PSMA radioligands so far, I would like to end my talk, and I would like to thank you for your attention.